Now, having changed the foot into a gathering foot, I'm going to turn the stitching to the full length and tighten the tension on the machine. Now, if you don't have a gathering foot, then you can manually do these gathers, although they're a lot harder. You would loosen the tension quite a bit and you would need to pull on the thread in order to get the gathering effect. So doing this on a foot that is meant for gathering is a lot easier, and it's one of the best investments that you can actually make. They're not very pricey, they're about £8 to £10 for industrial machines. A lot of the smaller machines, you get this part with the machine. And if you haven't, then I would suggest you purchase one of these parts, because they are absolutely a brilliant thing to have. So that is the one side of the gathering done. They are brilliant for doing frills on dresses. These are brilliant for doing frills on cushions and other bed linen. Because the tension is tight, you have to be careful and also make sure you've got plenty of thread at the bottom. What the machine is doing is it's penetrating through the fabric and it's actually pulling it along to form the gathered effect. So I'm doing this at the front and back, and then once having done this, I will attach the skirt to the bodice and make the whole garment into one. Hopefully attach the zip and do the side seams, and our garment inshallah will be complete. If these gathers are slightly bit loose and from the fitting of the dress, what we can do is just slightly by hand push these along to fit. I would rather have them slightly loose than have them tight. So having done this, we need to change our foot back to normal. Place your bodice area underneath. Make sure to set your machine back to normal, because we had the stitching in longer length and also the tension way too tight. Pick up your two pieces of the garment together and placing one on top of the other with the gathered side on top, attach the two together. So you are attaching this with the gathered side at the top to make it easier to incorporate a minor small gathering as you're going along, and also keeping an eye on the actual embroidery so that you don't go too much on top of the embroidery or the seam line. Now the seam line, initial seam line on the gathering part, you should cover this within the seaming, so seam above the original gathering seaming line. And I would encourage everyone to try and make this for Eid. It's a beautiful, beautiful outfit that will look stunning, which I'm going to hopefully, once my girl that I've made this for comes along, I will get her to try this on and hopefully show you the result of this. Now we're slowly pushing the fabric to actually take in and to fit onto the actual waistline. I mean, these dresses are only nice when they're nicely fitted, and obviously because we're going to put a zip on, we want it as well fitted as possible. Now having changed the needle, it's actually improved the running of the machine quite well. I know often people complain that we've got this problem and that problem, and something simple like changing the needle actually can. Now that is, having attached that, that's basically what it looks like now. So I'm going to do the exact same to the back of the dress. So we're going to work along on the back, again placing our back underneath and the gathered effect part on top, and attach all the way along. Again, this has been gathered very, very loosely. This was the first part that I did. So what I'm doing is pushing the fabric along in order to both the sides attached, and that basically is what the result looks like. Now I'm going to pause here because I will need to overlock the sides of this before attempting to do the side seam and attaching the zip on.